All of a sudden, from way across on Central Park West, I see a limo pull up to a stoplight. I know that it's him. I heard a voice in my head saying, do it, do it, do it. And as he passed me, I pulled the trigger 5 times.
It's now 14 hours since John Lennon was shot. As for the suspect,
Mark David Chapman.
Mark David Chapman.
Mark David Chapman.
I wasn't deprived in any way of anything. My mother loved me. My father loved me.
His dad bought him, when he was 8 years old, his first Beatle album.
And I remember playing that record over and over and over again.
Teenagers are at New York's Kennedy Airport to greet, you guessed it, the Beatles.
This isn't fame. This is something else.
John was a person with strong opinions about the world.
Seems a bit silly to be in America and for none of them to mention Vietnam as if nothing was happening.
He represented a spirit of man and ultimately the idealism that made John Lennon John Lennon.
He remembers being proud of being called a dirty hippie.
I was a hippie. It was the first time I'd ever been part of something.
John was getting drunk, he was depressed.
Mark began to go through serious bouts of depression.
It was like a train hitting another train on the same track head on. All of my nobodiness and all of his somebodiness collided. There was a successful man who had the world on a chain, and there I was, not even a link of that chain, and something in me just broke. Shortly thereafter, I was to think about killing John Lennon.
He had confided that he had other potential candidates on his so-called hit list.
There is a tornado in my mind, circling around my brain.
It was almost as if an emotional neutron bomb went off in New York City.
It's a sense of loss that's experienced every day since. Because every day, thousands of kids discover the Beatles. And there will always be that moment when that kid discovers that John Lennon was cut down in a hail of bullets on December 8th, 1980.
As he himself said, I didn't change the world, but I stopped it for 3 days.